There was an Amish wedding yesterday to our delight. Every Dutchman in the county was there with an appetite. We don't all get along so good, and yet we reunite whenever we're invited to a wedding. It was the bishop's daughter and the harness maker's son. Every district was invited, clear up to Highway 1. The house and barn was full of folks, and some were still to come. And the preacher started preaching at 8:30. There was Abe Yoder and Cho Yoder and Ben Yoder and John Yoder and Amos Yoder and Eli Yoder and Levi Yoder. He was there too. Well, the preacher preached till 9:30, and then he took a seat. The next one hemmed and hawed and coughed and stared down at his feet. He finally got him married, and then he said, "Let's eat, 'cause there's nothing like an Amish wedding dinner." There was chicken and potatoes and green beans and wedding steak, and beets and cheese and pickles, apple pie and chocolate cake, and ice cream, coffee, tea, and juice enough to fill a lake. And this was just the wedding meal's first helping. There was, you want to know who was there? Abe Troyer and Joe Troyer and Ben Troyer and John Troyer and Amos Troyer and Eli Troyer and Levi Troyer. Was he there? Yeah, he was there too. And then came meatballs made of pork and beef lightly browned, and bowls of mashed potatoes, about 100 pounds. And everyone went silent as the platters went around. There was no sound except for people chewing. I sat next to Eli Miller, now there's a tough old bird. We sat and chewed our dinner and we didn't say a word, 'cause everything we had to say we've already heard. So what's the use of pointless conversation? There was Abe Miller and Cho Miller and Ben Miller and John Miller and Amos Miller and Eli Miller and Levi Miller. He was there too. Joe raised his hand for silence, and then he told a joke about an Amish preacher didn't think before he spoke. And Bishop Miller laughed so hard I thought he had a stroke, and he blew some tapioca out his nostrils. The older men began to sing and passed around the books. The women washed the dishes in the kitchen with the cooks. The boys all watched the girls and they pretended not to look, 'cause they might just have themselves a date for supper. Then late that night we all went out and hitched up our buggies and came back to tell the girls that we're ready to go home. We said goodbye in the hallway, we said goodbye in the stairs, we said goodbye in the barnyard in the cold November air. We leaned against our buggy wheels and said goodbye from there, and we headed home from one great Amish wedding. There were Yoders and Troyers and Hostetlers and Schwarzentrubers and Hirschbergers and Weavers and Millers were there too. There were Beechies and Beilers and Bontragers and Burkholders and Kimes and Herbs and Chups and Fries and, well, I believe you was there too.